What's up guys, today's video is on the top 10 best tablelist in 2022. Through extensive research and testing, I've put together a list of options that'll meet we needs of different types of buyers. So whether it's price performance or its particular use, we've got you covered. For more information on the products, I've included links in the description box down below which are updated for the best prices. Like the video, comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Now let's get started. Tenth place. Apple iPad Pro 2021. Apple's super powerful M1 chip was dropped inside the already mighty iPad Pro 2021 this year, making the best even better. In Geekbench and Adobe Premiere Rush, that chip sets new tablet records, continuing Apple's tradition of packing a punch into its slim tablets. This 12.9-inch model also has Apple's Liquid Retina XDR display, which boasts a much brighter brightness of up to 1,588 nits. In addition, Apple has a new video conferencing feature called Center Stage, which tracks and follows you as you move during calls. Oh, and the fundamentals are still excellent. Its quad speaker setup is loud, the optional Magic Keyboard is comfortable to type on, and the battery life is better than last year's model, lasting hours longer than the Galaxy Tab S7 Plus. However, the super bright XDR display requires HDR content to thrive, which isn't always available. Hulu and HBO Max, for example, have yet to adopt it. Furthermore, the 12.9-inch iPad Pro 2021 costs more than the MacBook Air, and heavier when docked with its Magic Keyboard. However, for creative professionals looking for the best tablet for their next masterpiece, the iPad Pro 2021 is still worth it. 7th place. Samsung Galaxy Tab A7. Android users now have a true iPad competitor at a significantly lower cost. The Galaxy Tab A7 is a great 10.4-inch tablet for consuming content. It costs $229, and is frequently on sale for much less. Because of its super thin bezels, which are thinner than Apple's $329 iPad, you can focus more on your content whether you're browsing the web or streaming movies. It also has plenty of endurance, lasting 13 hours and 13 minutes on the Tom's Guide battery test. Oh, and it has a feature on the iPad Pro that Apple charges a premium for: facial recognition to unlock the device. The Galaxy Tab A7 charges via USB-C, just like Apple's more expensive tablets, so you can keep using non-reversible microUSB cables. While it isn't as fast as the iPad and the screen isn't as bright, neither of these factors are significant at this price. Especially 8th place. Apple iPad Mini 6/2021. Take almost everything we love about the iPad Air and reduce it to a size and weight that makes it super easy to use with just one hand, and you've got the iPad Mini 6/2021, which could be the iPad you've been waiting for. With the flat-edged design, much smaller bezels, and nearly everything else we love about an iPad, it supports the Apple Pencil too. With the pricing of its Fire Slates, Amazon currently has the market cornered on sub-10-inch tablets, but the new iPad Mini offers quality-conscious consumers an alternative worth investing in. You also have the super-fast A15 Bionic system on chip, which outperforms the iPad Air and every other non-pro iPad. It also has a bright display, over 500 nits, as well as surprising good sound for such a small device. Oh, and speaking of outperforming its size, the iPad Mini 6 offers excellent battery life. Is there anything about the iPad Mini 6 that isn't small? It costs $499, which is a little more than. 7th place. Samsung Galaxy Tab A7. Android users now have a true iPad competitor at a significantly lower cost. The Galaxy Tab A7 is a great 10.4-inch tablet for consuming content. It costs $229, and is frequently on sale for much less. Because of its super thin bezels, which are thinner than Apple's $329 iPad, you can focus more on your content whether you're browsing the web or streaming movies. It also has plenty of endurance, lasting 13 hours and 13 minutes on the Tom's Guide battery test. Oh, and it has a feature on the iPad Pro that Apple charges a premium for: facial recognition to unlock the device. The Galaxy Tab A7 charges via USB-C, just like Apple's more expensive tablets, so you can keep using non-reversible microUSB cables. While it isn't as fast as the iPad and the screen isn't as bright, neither of these factors are significant at this price. Especially since Samsung provides true Android with the Google Play App Store rather than the watered-down Amazon Fire tablet experience. 6th place. Samsung Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra. The Samsung Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra, $1,099, is the first tablet to cast a shadow on the iPad Pro. This Android slate, with its massive 14.6-inch OLED display, dwarfs the 12.9-inch iPad Pro in size. The Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra could potentially replace a laptop, thanks to the optional keyboard attachment and improved multi-window mode. With dual front cameras with up to 4K resolution for video calls and auto-framing to keep you in the frame as you move around, the Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra is clearly aimed at hybrid and at-home workers. Additionally, advanced noise reduction ensures that you are clearly heard. A fast Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chip, a low-latency S Pen experience, 45 watts fast charging, and improved integration with Galaxy S series phones are among the other features of the Tab S8 Ultra. The Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra costs $1,099, which is a lot of money. However, it offers an enticing combination of size, speed, and versatility, making it one of the best Android tablets available. Fifth place. Microsoft Surface Go 2. Sometimes it takes a second attempt to get something to work. The Surface Go 2 takes aim at the predecessor's flaws and eliminates them all. To begin with, thinner bezels allow for a larger screen, which is arguably the most important aspect of a tablet. The Surface Go 2's display is 10.5 inches, up from 10 inches on the previous model. The most significant improvement is the Surface Go 2's battery life, which is over 5 hours longer than the original Surface Go. Microsoft also granted my wish for a laptop with an excellent webcam. The top bezel's 5-megapixel 1080p camera is ideal for online video calls, and the second front camera sensor supports Windows Hello biometric login. Finally, the Surface Go 2 with the 8th generation Intel Core M3 upgrade is a little more expensive at $629, but it's the model for multitaskers. Fourth place. Lenovo Yoga Tab 11. The Lenovo Yoga Tab 11, $251, is a small and light Android tablet that's ideal for families with young children. It is a reliable entertainment-focused slate that is portable enough to carry around your home, despite its lack of impressive specs. I'll go over the Yoga Tab 11's key features, such as the built-in kickstand and Google Entertainment Space Hub, in this review. I'll also put it up against its bigger brother, the Lenovo Yoga Tab 13, to see how it compares. Overall, I think it's a great tablet for older kids and a decent tablet for people who just want to watch videos. Third place. Yoga Tab 13 by Lenovo. The Lenovo Yoga Tab 13 is an entertainment-focused Android tablet with a large 13-inch display and good speakers that make it feel like you're watching movies and shows on a big-screen TV rather than a bulky tablet. Thanks to the Snapdragon 870 processor and 8GB of memory, gaming is also a pleasure. The slate's 2K screen can also be used as a secondary monitor for your laptop or tablet, giving it even more versatility. Despite being excellent at what it does, it is not the most portable device available. Due to its unique design, finding a protective cover is nearly impossible. The lack of 5G support, as well as the lack of a headphone jack, is a disappointment. The Yoga Tab 13 is still a good choice if you're looking for an entertainment-focused tablet that you won't be carrying around much. Second place. Dell Latitude 7200 2-in-1. The Latitude 7200 feels like Dell's engineers were given the same brief as Microsoft's Surface team and produced a machine that is very similar. The end result is a functional tablet with a variable angle kickstand and a lightweight magnetically attached keyboard cover. Unlike Microsoft, Dell includes the keyboard cover in the standard price, and if you don't want it, you can get a refund of £92, roughly $110. However, because there is no rigid joint between the keyboard and tablet, and the kickstand has a very narrow blade, you can't use the Dell machine on your knees, as you can with the Surface. Dell has made Type-C charging a priority on this line, and you can charge from either of the left-hand ports. Micro SIM and micro SD card slots, a 3.5mm audio jack for headphones, and a volume rocker are all found on the left edge. A noble wedge lock can be found on the right. First place. Apple iPad Air, 2022. The iPad Air 4 is no longer available. The iPad Air 5 has taken its place. It strikes a balance between portability and performance. The new iPad Air 2022 is great for both consuming and creating content, and its starting price of $599 makes it affordable for most people. The addition of M1 elevates the iPad Air 2022 to the level of the iPad Pro. That's not to say the Air can now replace the Pro, but the power gap is much smaller. This, combined with its lower starting price, may make the new iPad Air more appealing than the iPad Pro for budget-conscious shoppers looking for the best iPad money can buy. In general, the new iPad Air is a near-perfect tablet. While there is still room for improvement, this sleek, powerful slate is difficult to put down. For the most part, this is the best tablet. Thank you for watching, and until next time, I hope to see you all in the next video. See you later, guys.